I
So,
understand you've also introduced the UNRWA Family Initiative Program.
yes,
Can you?
this is what we call a family health team. And then it's a bit we started in Gaza at first, before the war. Before the war, before even now, the main health problem for Palestinian refugees, so-called non-communicable diseases, diabetes and hypertension. Now, according to the World Health Organization statistics, probably 70 to 80% of causes of death for Palestinian refugees are non-communicable diseases. So non-communicable diseases, which includes diabetes, cardiovascular, cancer, and chronic respiratory, lung diseases, are the main health problem in Palestine. And in general, it is not to say that the death of mother or death of a baby is during the course of delivery. That era is finished, and it's more in the non-communicable diseases, like many middle-income countries. And then our challenge was that then how to address non-communicable diseases, particularly diabetes, hypertension, which we treat in our health center, in the 138 health center. Excuse me. And then then we ask many questions, what is the best way to deliver this? And then what I learned is that the family medicine is the best way. And let me explain the situation like this. Before the start of the reform of the family health team, our health center has three services, basically. One is the mother and child, second is diabetes, hypertension, the third one is ordinary walking or general chronic, three. And each room has different staff, and on top of it, each room has different medical records. So if I go to health centers and if I become a diabetes, I go to diabetes room, and I have my diabetes files. I don't get pregnant, but suppose if I get pregnant, I go to a mother and child room, and there is a pregnant record for me. And if I get the call that I go to the other place in the general walking clinic, they have another. So there are, in principle, there are three centers in the health centers, and this is a diabetes center, a pregnant center, and the common cold center. So it is a disease center delivery, service delivery. And this is not good for the as a health at large, but in particular for the communicable disease, also non-communicable disease or diabetes, hypertension, because it needs continuous care, and it needs a holistic approach. For example, that in case of diabetes, hypertension, diet is one of the most important treatment in reality. But in this part of the world, or like my classical Japanese like me, I don't cook, and they don't cook. Male don't cook. It's a wife cooks, and that's a reality of the life. And so, if I become diabetic, there's no sense that to tell me that you have to eat this, you don't need to eat this, you have to eat that, because I don't cook. So the doctor have to tell to my wife, your husband should eat this, should not eat this, and that is the family health. So that the family health is the doctors and the families have a continuous relationship. So the doctor can provide the continuous care, holistic care to the entire family to address not only the medical part, also the behavior part. And very first family health team of UNRWA actually started Beit Hanun, which is the battlefield now, totally unfortunately. And what they did in Beit Hanun, that they have six doctors in Beit Hanun. And so they divided two family health teams, one team for two doctors, two nurses, and one midwife. That's a composition they took. And then that they divided population into three geographical areas. So one team covers that area, the other team covers that area, the last team covers that area, and different areas, area A, area 1, 2, 3, and the team 1, 2, 3, it's allocated. So the population living in the area one always goes to team one, and also goes to the same doctor. So that in health center, there are team one, team two, team three, and then it's allocated within the health centers. And it was fantastic. It was truly very good. What was good is, firstly, patients are very happy because they said to have the same doctor every time, you don't need to explain everything. They know each other. Their family knows each other. And it's a real world that one of the patients in early days I went told me that my doctor is Dr. Noor, and it's one of the doctors there. And it's a beautiful world to me. And then that also by dividing this, the health center head was extremely good one. He reorganized the health center. This is a team one area, team two area, team three area. And then patient told, one of the patients told me that first time I never get lost in the health center. So which means that whenever they come to health center, they go to team one. The patient was for team one patient, so she simply went to team one.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever the reason is, instead of trying to find where to go, just go to there. And the doctor's very good. And then that for doctors and others, they're also very happy to see a family at large and every time see medically interested. And also what is interesting that each doctor now have a same number of patients, which is a very, very equal, fair to what they meant by in all days, walking clinic doctors have the highest number because all the common call, all these things, more than 120, 30 a day. While that mother and child, doctor working in mother and child clinic have the least number, usually 40, 50, because it's totally appointment basis, and then that they see only the sick mother and children, but mm-hmm. no sick nurse can deal. So some doctors are very high number, some doctors are very low number, so they are very, not fair. After familiar system, everybody has the same number. Yeah. That makes also doctors happy, fair.
Yeah.
And then by doing this, we also introduce appointment system other, so doctors' workload reduced. So it was a very good one. And then the community was very happy, and I really still hope that the health center that Hanoi remained. They had and they brought the communities, and the community were very happy with this innovation. And there are lots of health signs, like, you know, please don't smoke, or this is the side effect of diabetes, on the wall of the health center, very nice paintings. So it was a quite good model. It happens almost 2.5 years ago. And then since then that we've been converting many health centers gradually to different. And at this point of time, if we exclude Syria, which we have 110 health centers, excluding Syria, we have almost 70 health centers converted to this one. Target is by the end of the next year, 2015, we convert all the health centers, again, those outside Syria, to convert these family health teams.